Welcome back to my channel. I'm Vedan back again, and today we are going to discuss about Kala Dhan Multi Transit Corridor. So we will discuss Kala Dhan Corridor in 2 points. First, what is this Kala Dhan Multi Corridor project? And second, why is China worried after the Kala Dhan Multi Corridor Transit project? So first we will see what is this Kala Dhan Corridor project. See, to explain this, you may see the map that India is connected with its northeast states by a very thin corridor, as you can see here. This thin corridor is only 22 kilometers broad. This thin corridor is called the Siliguri corridor, and it is also called the chicken neck because its neck looks like a chicken neck. You have seen that the chicken's neck is very thin, its head is this side and body is this side. So that's why it got the name chicken neck. See, it has many problems, like it is very thin. Then if so many supplies are going towards the northeast, then there may be a problem of jam. Plus floods occur in Assam every day. If it comes here, then there may be connection issues with the northeast states. And third, if any country comes from here and cuts off the Siliguri corridor, it is very thin, any country can cut in less than half an hour. So, India were disconnected from its northeast states. China tried to do this in 2017 via the Doklam issue. We have heard in 2017 that Doklam issue. This is a Doklam region. It is between India, China and Bhutan. China tried to take this whole region. And China thought that it is Bhutan's internal affair, so India won't come. But India came because we thought that if China comes here and China occupies Doklam, then China will have an easy view of Siliguri corridor, and they will occupy the Siliguri corridor and they will cut off India's connection in northeast states. That's why India came in action and India and Bhutan pushed China out of Doklam. And this was China's always plan to cut off India's connection with northeast states. But why China wants to take India's northeast states? We all know that China occupied Tibet in 1949. Tibet was an independent kingdom, but China occupied it. And Arunachal Pradesh is said by South Tibet in China. So, China calls Arunachal Pradesh South Tibet and claims Arunachal Pradesh to be a part of India. That is why China wants to take India's northeast states. So see, we have either two options. Why go from Bangladesh or go to Myanmar? Go from Bangladesh will be a less expensive option because Bangladesh is very near. But if you build a highway through Bangladesh, then you all know the political instability of Bangladesh. If Sheikh Hasina comes and she supports India, if any other prime minister comes and she will be against India. So that is why we can't build a bridge across Bangladesh. Only one option is left now. Go through Myanmar. This is a good option because Myanmar has always been friends with India. So the Kala Dhan corridor goes through there. It starts from the Diamond Harbour, which is a port in Kolkata. Then the ships go through the Hooghly River. From the Hooghly River, then the ships will go to the Bay of Bengal, and then they will go to Sitwe port in Myanmar. This Sitwe port is actually in the construction and it is being constructed by the Indian authorities. And then from Sitwe, it will catch off in the Kala Dhan River. Kala Dhan River, from where it got its name. And then it will reach Paletwa. And from Paletwa, it will go to Zonpuri border crossing in India-Myanmar border region. And then it will go direct to Aizwan, the capital of Mizoram. See, this was its one benefit, that we will no longer be dependent on this Siliguri corridor. And second also that Myanmar government is planning a highway somewhere here which will straight go to Thailand. From Thailand it will go to Malaysia, and from Malaysia it will go straight to Singapore. So if we connect Paletwa with this highway, then Indian tourists can go to Singapore without planes, and India will have trade relations with Singapore also. And also we always had a thought that everything will be built in Delhi, Mumbai. Bullet train and Hyperloop, everything will come in Delhi, Mumbai. Nothing will come in this region. But now, when this Paletwa connects with this highway, then there will be a thing that if from Diamond Harbour or from Aizwal, we can connect to Singapore. So this was the benefits. Now we will move to why is China worried after this corridor, after this Kaladan corridor. See if China sees that this Kaladan corridor is complete, then its old plan of cutting through the Siliguri corridor will be vanished. It will be vanished. It will not work now. Plus, if India builds this corridor, India will have good trade relations with Myanmar and other South Asian countries. And so that will also be a great trouble for China. That is why China doesn't want that this project should be completed. Till now, the progress is that from Diamond Hawa to Situate, everything has been completed. From Situate to Paleto also, Kaladan River has been gone little deep so that the ships can go. Just from Paleto to Zonepuri border crossing, the progress is under construction. And so, in this video I told you about that Kaladan corridor and its benefits and why China doesn't want it to exist. And that's it. If you like this video, give it a big thumbs up, share it, and please subscribe my channel. Thank you, friends.